time for another eFIXX tool review, and today we're looking at the WIHA Picofinish Electric Precision Screwdriver Set.
Well done.
Whoa, I don't know who comes up with these product names, that was a mouthful.
Well, the product might be a mouthful to say, but we've had these screwdrivers out for the last 4 or 5 weeks in the actual workshop, and we absolutely love them, Gordon.
We do, and, you know, precision, Gary, what do you think first when I think precision? What comes to your mind?
Well, I'm going to have to slip the spectacles on, because I'd imagine we're going electronics.
Yeah, and that's what we're happening more and more in the electrical industry, is electronics are creeping into installations, and as it creeps in, terminal sizes shrink, and possibly you need a smaller screwdriver set to properly get to those terminals.
Yeah, don't want a really long screwdriver when it's mounted on a PCB board. You might get the torque set and pop it off.
Yeah, and you know, you can't use these, Gary, for levering paint tin lids off, poking around in the building fabric to try and locate those cables or joists.
Well, the keen-eyed amongst you might have noticed we've already used these screwdrivers in a previous race. So let's cut to that little bit of footage. This is when I destroyed the Speede 2 with my screwdriver.
I think you just destroyed your wrist in that video, Gary, if I seem to remember rightly. If you haven't seen that, it is an absolute treat to watch that. You will see where you can and can't use this screwdriver. It's one of those applications in DIN rail terminals, but perhaps if you're not doing quite as many as we were in that race.
No, so where have we been using it and where have we found it brilliant to use it?
Okay, so the first thing we think about is dimmer switches. So we've been doing a series recently looking at dimming LEDs, and we certainly found that most dimmer switches in the UK installations have small terminals. So what did you use in that one, Gary?
Yeah, I used a 2.5mm flat screwdriver in order to facilitate the terminals in the back of that dimmer. And then I went on and I actually did the back of a dimmer that's slightly different this time. What do I use it for now?
Yeah, so you'll find that a lot of dimmer switches also have a potentiometer in the back. Again, that's a quite a sensitive electronic component which needs a precision screwdriver to not damage it as you're setting the dimmed level.
Yeah, so we use that screwdriver just to bring the low end of that dimming lamp down. So again, a really good use of that tool. So what else have we been doing with it?
Well, we've also found that recently more and more Euro modules now. We had this small Euro module that's a USB charger.
We did.
And again, that's got small terminals on the back of it.
It has, and again, you can see the electronics through the green that you obviously wouldn't want to be wrenching against those terminals, and this screwdriver works a treat for that. Yeah. Let's have a closer look at one of the screwdrivers, because there's another little nice touch to it as well, Gordon, so you want to pop that one out for us?
Well, there's two nice touches, Alec, yeah? Right, one is this little swivelly toppy.
Okay, yeah, I like
which
that.
Helps you when you're, if you want to hold it steady and try and get some speed up. You didn't do that in that race, but that's what you should have done.
I did win.
And you'll also notice on the top,
let's have a look,
the size of the screwdriver is nice and clearly printed on the top.
Okay, yeah.
Which can be a bit of a problem, because if you look at the smallest screwdriver in this range, it's absolutely tiny.
It is. Where would we use that sort of screwdriver, that really, really small screwdriver?
Well, I think the best one for you, Gary, is using it to repair your glasses.
Oh, right, okay, yes. So the only problem I find is when you're making a repair to the glasses, you probably need the glasses on in order to be able to see the screw head. So that's one thing I do find. It was a little bit of using the force there in order to do so.
Yeah, so there's that, and then also we're starting to see small terms on things like smart thermostats.
We are,
so yeah. We had a look at a Nest thermostat in a lot of our Feral videos.
Yeah.
But this, we found a little small Phillips head screwdriver fits incredibly well into the terminals you find in the Nest.
Yeah.
And then also more recently, we used it on the My Energy Eddy.
Yeah, when we opened that up, that was full of green PCB boards and the glasses were slipped on nice and early there in order that we can make those connections.
Yeah, so in there they have some very small terminals for the current transformer that has a couple of cable connections to those. And that's possibly the thing about PCB terminals. The fact these are a small screwdriver means you're less likely to, sort of, should I suggest, over-torque them and wrench the PCB terminal off the circuit board.
And when you say small, you mean physically in length small, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, that's it, yeah. So that's, ideal. I mean, and I've had a set similar to this for a long time that just wasn't insulated, actually.
Oh, right, okay, yeah, okay. Now, we also saw some screwless DIN rail connections made by WAGO or WAGO, depending on how you want to say it, and they came with something that they described as not a screwdriver. Let's bring the camera in to not look at this screwdriver. Okay. So that is not a screwdriver provided by WAGO.
No, it's an operating tool, Gary, with a partially insulated shaft.
Can you just demonstrate what that was used for me?
Okay, so that just you push that into these screwless top job DIN rail terminals.
Okay.
And then you can put your conductor in with a ferrule release and take it out.
Okay. So that was using a partially insulated...
operating tool.
Operating tool. Got another lovely name. But we thought that maybe these screwdrivers could be used for this as well.
Yeah, surprise, surprise. Yeah.
Even though this is a screwdriver, not to be mistaken for a partially insulated shaft. Oh, right, they work a treat as well.
It does exactly the same job, so...
So could we say that we could use the screwdriver on a screwless connector?
Yeah.
I like that. Yeah, that's why they can't call that a screwdriver.
Yeah, or you might be able to use it to poke around in the roof to find joists.
Okay. Any other places you want to take us with this screwdriver set?
So the other thing it comes with, I mean, you like a pouch, Gary, don't you? So
I do love a pouch. Yeah. Now, when I open up my pouch, and I had a look earlier on, the smallest tip on mine was 2.5 mil.
Yeah.
And then that was it, really. I jumped straight up then to a larger size one, and that tip being, let me just have a look, my eyesight's not great with glasses on, that's 4 millimeters. So yeah, I've got 2.5 and 4.
So this set starts at 3 millimeters and goes all the way down to 1.5, which is the tiny one you use for your glasses. Also comes with two Philips, a Philips 00 and a Philips 0.
Okay, so whereas this pouch is ideal perhaps to the actual contractor, and that's why I really like it. Actually, when we start looking at the electronics aspects, this screwdriver set isn't adequate, and I'm probably gonna need another one. It also, you can mount it. So there's a couple of little fixings here. So if it was used in a workshop, okay, it can be mounted. A little bit of a drawback I would suggest is that the sizes of them can be seen, but you'd have to mount it really high in order to look underneath.
Yeah, right? Or upside down.
Upside down, yeah, maybe you could mount it upside down.
Upside down, you can see them there. But unfortunately,
the tray then doesn't.
The tray where you can put your little screws in, or probably the ones you lose anyway. That wouldn't work, would it?
Not quite. And what I also like about the tray is that in all the time we've had this set, we have been very keen to return them to the tray, and we've got them all. I think if they came separate, we would have had to have been hunting around the studios in order to find the rest of them.
That's a fair point, Gary. But if you were on site, it might be nice to have a pouch.
Oh, yeah, it's always nice to have a pouch if you're on site, I would suggest, and I love a pouch. So, the screwdriver set here from WIHA, which you're going to remind us of the name.
Oh, thanks. It's the Picofinish Electric Precision Screwdriver Set.
Okay, so when you're asking your apprentice to go to the van, you'd ask him to get what, Gordon?
The Picofinish Electric Precision Screwdriver Set.
Okay, maybe the small screwdrivers on the stand were maybe what you'd be asking for. But we think they're perfect for what we've used them around the workshop for these electronic-based terminations, especially on our dimming series and the stuff we did with MyEnergy. As always, we're interested in your screwdriver stories. What's your go-to set when you're working on precision stuff? We're not using them for knocking holes in ceilings when we're making those electronic connections. Please leave those comments below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.